Hi guys, welcome to another video, you know, on the Career Launcher YouTube channel. Do go ahead and subscribe to our channel in order to get regular updates on the new videos that we keep coming up with, specifically oriented to the MBA exams, the law exams, the banking exams, and so on and so forth. Anything that you want to find out about, entrance examinations in India, which are related to aptitude, well, this is your one-stop solution. Let's spend a little bit of time today, on the ZAT previous year exam analysis. So let's actually have a look at what the ZAT paper has had in store for students since 2016 to 2020. What is the paper pattern like? How much does a student need to score section-wise in order to be certain of clearing the sectional cutoffs? What kind of a score you should be looking at in order to be certain of clearing the overall cutoffs, and so on and so forth. That's predominantly what we'll go ahead and talk about in today's session. Let's actually start off right at the beginning with looking at what the pattern has been in ZAT over the last few years. So if you're looking at it from 2016 to 2020, you will see that the total number of questions, ZAT has kind of hit more or less a sweet spot. It's very, very similar to CAT, where the number of questions has been predominantly around 100 till in 2020, CAT came out and stated, no, we'll change from a 3-hour paper, it'll become a 2-hour paper. In a very similar way, ZAT over the last 5 years, the number of questions has been in and around the 75 mark. The highest that it's been is about 78. The lowest it's been is at about 72. Expected for ZAT 2021, well, once again, around the 75 mark. 75 question, mark. The reason being, once again, they've gone ahead and announced that the ZAT paper is a 3-hour paper, which means 165 minutes for section one. And what do I call section one? Section one is basically the part which comprises verbal, quant, data interpretation, and so on and so forth. Which means this part that we are talking about here, this is something that we like to go ahead and deem as section one. This is what we like to deem as section two. And there is about a generally some amount of 2 to 3 minutes gap in between these two papers and two sections. Now, when you think about ZAT, always keep in mind that the second paper, which is predominantly the general awareness paper, there is no real cutoff that XLRI looks at when it comes to this general awareness section. So even if you end up scoring zero, it's okay. However, in say 1 or 2 out of 100 cases, which means 1 to 2% of the people who actually get to the interview stage, they might cross question you on a couple of things or a couple of questions that might have come up in the general awareness section. So not very important when it comes to going ahead and actually scoring marks and getting a call from XLRI, SPGen and other top institutes. But yes, it might come up in your interviews, not necessary. So do keep that in mind. When I'm looking at it from the verbal perspective, well, predominantly around the 26 mark, more or less stable here. Let's look at 2020 as a benchmark. So 26 is stable. Quant, somewhere around the 28 mark. So it's ranged from 27 to 29. So 28 is a good median, or you can say mean, to consider. Decision making in and around the 21 mark again. So, predominantly a 75 question paper, so more or less stagnant. Let's look at it from a marks per question perspective in terms of the pattern. So as I stated, ZAT 2021, we expect it to be once again around the 75 question mark overall. The marks per question, we expect it to be very similar, which is plus one minus 0.25. There's a slight difference here. ZAT has this tendency and tenacity to go ahead and come up with something called a differential marking scheme, where they are trying to penalize candidates who do not attempt a lot of questions. So look at the note that I've stated here. If a candidate leaves over 8 questions in the ZAT paper, there is a penalty of 0.1 marks for every question after the 8 question mark. So imagine, there are 12 questions which I have not attempted in the paper. So 12 minus 8 is 4 questions. 4 into 0.1, 0.4 will be the penalty applied. Generally, the penalty applied is in the ratio of the total number of questions in the section. Okay, so that's how they generally go about it. When it comes to the general awareness paper, which is paper 2, well, there is no negative marking there. It's plus 1 and no negative. So go ahead, ensure that you attempt all 25. There's absolutely nothing to lose. Okay, so that's more or less the pattern. So generally, this question comes up 165 minutes, how to go ahead, devise the time, break up, and so on and so forth. The way I look at it is, see, decision making 21 questions. This generally means about 6 to 7 sets, a data set is given, followed by 3 or 4 conditional questions on what you would do in these kind of situations. It generally doesn't take more than 40 to 45 minutes. Okay, so that's generally predominantly the amount of time it seems like. Now, if you go to the verbal section, 26 questions, the vocab questions or say the direct questions on grammar would be easy. The RC questions might take a little bit of time. Critical reasoning might take a little bit of time. So generally about 50 to 55 minutes would be ideal here as well. That means the remaining time, which is close to about 60 to 65 minutes, is what you can go ahead and put in quant and try to actually ace this section. Okay. How to look at every section, we'll talk about, you know, as we move forward. This is basically what the percentile cutoffs have been. Now, I've once again gone ahead and given you the entire picture since 2016 to 20. The basic crux of that is actually in the table below. If you look at the table below, the crux of that is if you're looking at it from BM perspective for XLRI, verbal, look at an 80 plus, DM, look at a 90 plus, quant, look at an 80 plus, overall 96 plus, it is safe. Irrespective of what the cutoffs have been over the last 5 years, this is the max of all of them. So it is safe if you end up scoring percentiles in this range. Similarly, in HRM, verbal is slightly higher at 85, the other two lower at 75, overall at 94.5. If you look at last year, it was about 96, 94.5. The previous year, 96, 92.5, then 94, 92, and so on and so forth. Okay. So overall, just to be very, very safe, because we don't know what will happen again in 21, this is this percentile cutoffs you should be looking at. What does that translate into marks? Well, we've gone ahead and done that for you as well. In terms of marks, well, the ideal is for verbal, for BM specifically, verbal look at 8 plus, DM 9 plus, QA plus DI 12 plus, keep that in mind, 12. So quant plus DI, you need that extra time because you're looking at the highest marks there. Okay, keep that in mind. HRM, verbal 9, DM about 8.5, quant again DI around 8.5, and overall at 35 or 32.5. Now here, you can see that the level of difficulty of the paper keeps changing, which is why if you just look at, for example, ZAT 2020, and we all know ZAT 2020 was an anomaly. You know, ZAT has this tendency, once every decade, they come up with a paper which you don't know, you can't make head or tails, about it. It happened in ZAT 2011, again in ZAT 2020, so ZAT 2021, you're safe. I think you don't need to worry too much about it. It won't be a sudden shocker. But yeah, if I'm looking at ZAT 2020 vis-a-vis the other years, you'll suddenly see a drop of almost 10 marks. You know, look at this at ZAT 2020, 21.46, ZAT 2017, 35. It's almost a drop of about 14 to 15 marks. That's humongous. Okay, so which is why level of difficulty is very, very important. Write enough number of mocks, you know, practice enough number of previous year ZAT actual papers to understand that, you know, you are able to identify the level of difficulty and thereby mold how you are attempting the paper, because 165 minutes is a long time for you to be able to change your strategy midway. If you suddenly realize, for example, last year, just look at the verbal cutoffs, just look at it, 2.6, 3.38, that's barely anything, okay? And, for female candidates, in most cases, it was almost 0.5 to 1 mark lesser. That means just imagine for VALR, it could be somewhere around 2.1, which is you attempt 3 questions, get them all correct and you're done. Matlab, just imagine spending 40 minutes, attempt 3 questions and you're done. But do you realize that while writing the paper? That is important. Okay. So please keep that in mind. Keep the safe scores in mind. You know, as I always state, according to me, taking a target and going into the exam is easier. Keep changing, molding. When you look at the paper, you realize, no, it's easy, so I can go 2017 way. No, it's difficult, I can go 2019 or 2018 way. No, it's very, very difficult and weird, I can go 2020 way. Okay, just keep that in mind. Section-wise analysis, well, in general knowledge, not a lot to really talk about. Not really a very, very important section either. Look at the, you know, GK compendium that has been uploaded by Career Launcher and Aspiration.ai. Go through that should be good enough. In general, the breakup, if you look at it, you know, there is a lot of focus generally on stuff like geography, science and tech, history and economy and business. So just keep that in mind and focus a little bit there. In quant and data interpretation, now keep this in mind, you know, on an average, about 8 questions are DI. Now, generally, they are slightly time consuming, but just look at it. If you're spending 65 minutes here and you tell yourself for the 3 DI sets, I give myself 20 minutes. That means close to about 7-8 minutes per DI set, or 20 minutes, 8 questions, or 25 minutes. That's about 3 minutes per question, or 2.5 minutes per question. That's a long time. That means you have time to utilize the options, estimate, guesstimate, and move ahead and answer. So please don't think of DI as a part of the paper which you will not attempt. Don't go in with that strategy. There is enough time, and out of the 8 questions, 5-6 can surely be answered. Look at it, you know, in terms of the last year paper itself, ZAT 2020. Even though the overall marks are very difficult, look at DI. Everything is moderate or easy to moderate. Somebody just would have spent about 25-30 minutes here, you could have gotten your 5-6 marks and you're stable. Okay. As always in any MBA exam, arithmetic, about 8 questions, lot of weightage. Geometry, this is one of those papers where geometry gets more weighted than algebra. Doesn't generally happen, but in ZAT, that, you know, it's known to happen. So do keep that in mind. Geometry is important. Do prep a little. You still have a little bit of time. Do put in your effort. You know, arithmetic and geometry, if you've gone ahead and handled, you basically handled close to about 65-70% of the paper. So in CAT, we used to constantly say arithmetic algebra. Here, it's more like arithmetic geometry. So keep that in mind, okay? Verbal, well, once again, 4 RCs, 3 questions per RC, and look at what I've written. The level of difficulty last year, moderate to difficult, not easy. It does take time. You will take time reading those passages. You might take as much as, in certain cases, 8 to 9 to 10 minutes per passage, which means even for 3 questions per passage, you're basically looking at about 10 minutes. So that's almost close to about 35-40 minutes that you might take for RCs, which is why I'm okay if you turn around and you state that overall I'll take about 55 minutes in this section. Generally, critical reasoning, these 6 questions, you can do about 1.5-2 minutes. So even if you take about 10 minutes here, you take about 40 here, that's about 50. This combined, you know, if I'm looking at this part combined, you will not take a lot of time. At max, you'll take about 4 to 5 minutes. So overall, if you want to attempt everything, also you won't take more than about 55 minutes. One, you know, different kind of a question that generally comes here is a poem comprehension. Please keep your eyes open for that. You know, a lot of preparation happening there as well. Do attend the session that we've had on the poem comprehension and how to attempt it, because it's something unique to ZAT and it constantly keeps coming up every year. Finally, the decision-making analytical reasoning section, we all know what that is. Generally, there is one set on analytical reasoning that comes up. Last year, even that wasn't there. Everything was DM. So generally, about 6-7 sets of DM, go ahead, understand the situation and answer basis the situation. Keep ethicality very, very high. Keep, you know, logic very, very high. And those two will help you reach the right answer. So that's predominantly what the ZAT paper has thrown up over the last 4 to 5 years. Do keep certain things in mind. Other than quant, other sections, single digits are basically your cutoffs. Try judging the level of difficulty of the paper. Write enough number of mocks, you know, previously to be able to judge the paper. Enough time at your disposal. Don't get flustered if you're not being able to answer something. It is not an easy paper, okay? Predominantly a very, very difficult paper. Last year, if you look at it, 20 on 75, that's nothing. Barely 30% of the total marks. In general, it will revolve around 40-42% of the total marks of the paper, which means a score of about 30-32 generally is safe enough to get at least one call from XLRI, hopefully even SPGen if your profile is good. For IMT and others, you could look at 2 marks lesser. That's predominantly what you need to keep in mind. For the decision-making session, you know, we all know it's a unique section devoted to that. There is a specific course called ZAT DM1000, you know, where GP, Gijo and I, we've gone ahead and recorded a set of videos. Go ahead, capture, you know, enroll yourself in that. Have a look at that. You know, it might really go ahead and help you a little bit. For others looking at specific courses, well, you can go ahead and, you know, be ready for the ZAT analysis that will come from Career Launcher on careerlauncher.com/CAT-MBA/ZAT. If you're looking for, you know, specific courses online in terms of online classes or DM1000 and so on and so forth, just to understand how to prepare specifically for ZAT, a crash course kind of a thing, just 10-12 days, go ahead and have a look at it. In case you have any specific queries in terms of how to prep for ZAT, what is going on, feel free to, you know, drop me a mail. I'll try to revert back. And in case you have any specific queries regarding inquiries that you might have regarding the programs, you know, go ahead and feel free to give a call at these numbers. That's about it. As always, do go ahead and, you know, subscribe to the Career Launcher YouTube channel for, you know, getting constant updates on what it is that we are going to go out and keep coming up with. Do catch us for the actual ZAT analysis happening on the 3rd of January. We'll meet you straight after the exam. All the very best, guys. Do very well.